cancel.
Schweezy.
Why do studios pay millions in licensing for IP for book series, then completely ignore the source material? Two good and very relevant examples at the moment would be The Wheel of Time and The Witcher series. It's fascinating when you do a side-by-side comparison of these with the books that they are supposed to be based on and realize that 50% or more of the TV series is made up entirely with different plot lines, characterizations, etc. It seems bizarre for a company to pay as much as they are for the rights to essentially the use to use the names and titles from an existing series when it's fairly evident that the writers and showrunners want to do something completely original. Is this just a case of studio executives initiating an idea, then it's going off the rails when production begins, or are these situations entered where they know they are going to be creating something vastly different and the rights to the name are basically an attempt to capitalize on existing names recognition until they can capture their own audience? So, I haven't watched The Witcher on Netflix, though. I love Henry Cavill. I'm going to be honest. I love the Snyder DC Universe. I'll tell you, I like Ben Affleck. Isn't that Ben Affleck? Ben Affleck. I didn't say Ben Affleck or Ben Affleck. I like Ben Affleck as Batman. I think costume-wise, I think he does a good job with the character. I think Ben Affleck is a good character. And I think if you watch actual Snyder Cuts, so you watch the Snyder Cut of the Justice League, and you watch the director's cut of Batman v. Superman, I think it's really good. I think Batman v. Superman, the director's cut, is really good because it's very slow-paced. That's Zack Snyder's style, very slow-paced. And it actually makes sense why everything happens. It's on HBO Max, so don't be stingy.
Come on, Mark, don't be stingy.
I guess you're talking about The Witcher, so that's why I brought it. And Henry Cavill, video games, they want to make... So with that situation, they're wanting to make something that's different from the video games, but is good on its own. That's where they're switching away from the source material. I think there's a book with it too. Henry Cavill is great. I learned he built his own PC. He almost was late for his Superman audition because he was doing a World of Warcraft raid. I start liking Henry Cavill a little bit more now than I did before. So I know they're going off subject, so I guess they're going off source material. And I guess Game of Thrones, which is another series I didn't watch. I want to talk about a series I did pay a lot of attention to, and that went slightly off source material. That is anything in the Harry Potter universe. Now, I'm a big Harry Potter fan. For those of you who didn't know, I will go off all day on how much I love this fucking series. So they went a lot off source material. So one idea I would say that they did, because when you read a book, there is a difference when you write screenplay, what is actually on screen, what's filming, versus a book. Because in a book, you have to describe what's going on. In a film, you have to show what is going on. Totally, completely different situation. A totally different thing. So that is a big thing. And there's also studio involvement. Warner Brothers is big on this with Marvel. Disney is their overlord and stuff like that. So if they're interested. So let's just go with Marvel and Disney. Marvel, they obviously make their own movies, and they base it off some comic book stories, but they're not 100% they're not accurate to the source material or whatever the fuck they're doing. Disney is interested in making a sale, getting people to watch, making money. What Marvel is interested in, because Kevin Feige is telling a good story. And luckily, telling a good story, getting people interested in the product, and making sales with Disney wants is a good combination of the two. So it's a weird thing. When I talk about Harry Potter, do I wish there was a lot of changes I wish they did? 100%. I wish they would make a lot more changes. But can I change it now? No, because it's 2021, almost 2022, And Goblet of Fire came out in 2005, I believe. So, yeah, I can't change things even if I tried. Well, look at you. You just finished one of the many highlights from Cancel Schweezy. Glad you watched, and I hope you learned something important in your life today. We have more highlights available for you to watch out now, available now for you to watch. And we got full episodes as well. So don't be stingy and go watch another highlight. And like I said, stay awesome.